Hello children, I am Prasanna. In this video, I am going to explain angles made by the transversal with the two lines. Okay, so total 9 types of angles I have discussed in the last video, children. So from based on that, we are going to write in a simple manner. Okay, here I am considering two lines L and this is M. And this is what transversal N, because it is intersecting the other two lines at different points. So when a line intersects other two lines, we will get 8 angles. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. For our convenience, we are writing, you can take alphabets also. 5, 6, 7, 8. So using these 8 angles, we will consider different pairs of angles. In that, first one I am writing, children, exterior angles. So what are exterior angles? Here if you see exterior, 1, 2, 7, 8, okay? So angle 1, angle 2, angle 7 and angle 8 are exterior angles. Coming to next, interior angles. So easy to write interior angles, here inside of the figure. So angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6 are the 4 interior angles. Coming to next, vertically opposite angles. So total you are going to get 4 pairs of vertically opposite angles. When we consider what are vertically opposite angles, actually when two lines intersect, the angles which are formed opposite to each other are called vertically opposite angles. If you consider this 1, 2, 3, 4, here you are going to get angle 1 and angle 3 as one pair, angle 2 and angle 4 as one pair. Next, if you see 5, 6, 7, 8, angle 5 and angle 7 as one pair, angle 6 and angle 8 as a one pair. Okay, so totally you are going to get 4 pairs of vertically opposite angles. Next one, alternate interior angles. So what are alternate interior angles? Both should be interior and they should not be adjacent, and they should be on either side of a transversal. If you see this 3, 4, 6, 5, these are 4 angles are interior, and here what are the angles? Angle 3 and angle 5 as one pair of alternate interior angles, because they are not adjacent, they are interior, and 3 is on the left side of a transversal and 5 is on the right side of a transversal. So one pair is 3 and 5 and another pair is 6 and 4. So totally we are going to get alternate interior angles into how many pairs, children? 2 pairs. Okay, next, coming to alternate exterior angles. So here we should consider only exterior angles here, and both should be exterior and they should not be adjacent and they should be on either side of a transversal. If you take in this first one, angle 2 and angle 8 as a one pair of alternate exterior angles, and 1 and 7 as one another pair of alternate exterior angles. So totally we are going to get 2 pairs of alternate exterior angles. Next one, corresponding angles. So what are corresponding angles, children? Both should be on the same side of a transversal, and one should be interior, one should be exterior, and they should not be adjacent. If I take 1 and 5 is one pair, 1 is exterior, 5 is interior, and they are not adjacent and they are on the same side of a transversal. So I can take here angle 1 and angle 5 as one pair of corresponding angles. Next, 4 and 8. If you see, 4 is interior, 8 is exterior, on the same side of a transversal, and they are not adjacent. So you can take 4 and 8 as one pair. Coming to other side of a transversal, 2 and 6. Okay, here 2 and 6, and coming to next, 3 and 7. So totally we are going to get 4 pairs of corresponding angles. Next one, interior angles on the same side of a transversal. Interior angles on the same side of a transversal. So what are interior angles here? 3, 6, 4 and 5 are the interior angles, and they should be on the same side. So here 3 and 6. 3 and 6 is one pair. Next 4 and 5 is the another pair. So totally you are going to get 2 pairs of interior angles on the same side of a transversal. Now we will take exterior angles. Exterior angles on the same side of a transversal. So we should consider only exterior here. 1, 2, 7, 8 are the exterior angles. They should be on the same side of a transversal. So here one pair is angle 2 and angle 7 and another pair is angle 1 and angle 8. So two pairs of exterior angles on the same side of a transversal we are going to get. And finally we are going to write linear pair. So what is linear pair? Sum of two adjacent angles is equal to 180 degrees. When I consider 1, 2, 3, 4, you are going to get angle 1 plus angle 2 as 180, angle 2 plus angle 3 as 180, angle 3 plus angle 4 as 180, next angle 4 plus angle 1 as 180. So whenever the two lines intersect, you will get 4 pairs of linear pair. Coming to here 5, 6, 7, 8, here also we are going to get angle 5 plus angle 6 as 180, angle 6 plus angle 7 as 180 degrees, angle 7 plus angle 8 as 180, next angle 8 plus angle 5 is also 180 degrees. So finally these are the angles made by a transversal with the two lines children. We get 4 exterior angles, 4 interior angles, 4 pairs of vertically opposite angles, 2 pairs of alternate interior angles, 2 pairs of alternate exterior angles and 4 pairs of corresponding angles, 2 pairs of interior angles on the same side of a transversal and 2 pairs of exterior angles on the same side of a transversal and there are 8 pairs of linear pair. So when you get the question children, they will give one diagram for you, they will mark angles, they may give 1, 2, 3, 4 or ABCD, they will ask, write all the angles made by the transversal.